Praise the Lord. You don't say praise the Lord here? I travel so many churches, I'm very scared whether to raise hand someplace, whether to say praise the Lord, whether to say hallelujah. But I know Capstone, you don't mind me saying praise the Lord, right? Can I hear a praise the Lord back? Praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Okay, so glad to be here once again and joy to meet you all this afternoon. And I'm sure the Lord is at work in this church, and there are greater things that are coming to us. Not because God wants to make us great, just because He is great. And He reveals His greatness through us. So whatever God does in this world, we must remember it is all about Him. And we are His instruments. We are His people, chosen for a particular purpose in our lives. So this afternoon, I would like to thank the Lord for keeping me with you. And it's always a joy to share the word. It's always a joy to fellowship with people who love Him. And Capstone is very close to my heart as we serve together in many places. This morning I was saying, it's been a long time I spoke at a Sunday service of Capstone, but I keep meeting many Capstonians otherwise at different meetings and different works that we do together. So I want to greet you once again, and I want to congratulate you for all that you are doing. But I believe even as the best is yet to come, even the best is yet to come out of you too. I think you have not explored your own potential in the Lord. There are greater things that await you, that await the world through you. So this morning I want to talk to you especially about missions, what this mission is all about. This is my 19th year in missions. In 2000, I began my journey in the mission work. Began as a medical missionary, serving the Lord in different mission hospitals. 2010, the Lord called me out of my medical work. And then I've been serving the churches, serving the missions, and various ways that God has enabled me to. This month, in fact, I'll finish my 19 years. I'll be entering 20th year next month. So it's a great joy to serve Him. And it's a great joy to celebrate Him through the world, through whatever He's doing. So morning I was short of time, so I had to rush through the sermon, but I gave them what they needed from the Lord. But now I know that second service, there is no third service. And I'm also told that there is some cafe down here, so you can eat lunch and go, no problem. Okay. So I'll take little time, maybe 35 minutes. Please bear with me. Because the Lord has placed something special for all of us. Morning I spoke from life of Joseph a little bit, but this afternoon I want to speak from the life of Moses on missions. This is with me. God speaks to different groups differently. I can't repeat a sermon. I don't know why. God doesn't allow me to do that. I thought maybe I'll repeat it, get away from this church. Two services, no, nothing doing. You have to speak a different one. The topic will be same. Maybe the headings will be same, but the life that we're going to look at this afternoon is Moses. How many of you know Moses from the Bible, right? You're all good Christians, you all know your Bible. So we'll not dwell too much on Bible verses, but we would definitely look through the life of Moses to understand what mission means to us and what mission means to God. We'll look at that. Moses is a very interesting character. His life is divided into 340 years, right? 40 years as a prince, 40 years as a, what I call in Hindi, gharjamai, happy life, okay? Not so happy actually, we'll figure it out. And the third journey is the most difficult journey of his life, but most blessed journey of his life. So we want to see what God does in Moses' life, beginning with the second half of his life. Exodus chapter 3, turn with me, if you have your Bibles. And if it can be projected on screen, it will be great, so that people can be spared of opening it in this little darkness. So Exodus chapter 3, this is a very beautiful setting where God is calling Moses for something great that awaits. But very interestingly, we see where Moses is. Chapter 3, verse 1, I'm reading from ESV version. It says, "Now Moses was keeping the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the priest of Midian. And he led his flock to the west side of wilderness and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. He looked, and behold, the bush was burning, yet it was not consumed. So one of the most popular incidents in Bible. You know, we do it in Sunday school, we do a lot of drama, skit, even some of us watch those movies also on this. But very interesting place where God begins to converse with him. An interesting place because here he is after having left the position of authority. Let's understand this. He was what? He was a prince, right? Before this. But now he ran away from that place. I assume all of you know the story. I hope you know the story, okay? So now after that happened to him, he's sitting here in a place where he's tending not his own flock, but a father-in-law's flock. I think that's the worst job ever you can imagine. Ghar jamai to theek hai. You don't even own your flock. What a shameful job. And all lonely somewhere in the wilderness. So what God was laying on my heart, and he was reminding me that God doesn't care where you stand, what your standing is. If God has a purpose for your life, he can use you from wherever you are. Even if you are nothing, in fact, I think that's a better place for us to start with God. Moses was absolutely nothing. He owned nothing. He lost his position. He was run away. And he is living in a place where he has no authority whatsoever. But then God begins to converse with him. You know this conversation, and a miracle happens. He goes up near there. Then God begins to share something very interesting to him. So I want to encourage you that missions, when we are talking about, remember the beginning is from the Lord. It is all about God. Mission is never about a church. It's never about an organization. It's never about you and me. I've been a missionary all these years. I can tell you confidently, it is definitely not about me. If it was about me, it is not a mission. It's commission. There is a difference. It's not about us. It is about our master. There is an acronym I made. You can display it now. About mission. Let's begin with M of mission. It's about master. Moses was doing nothing to God. He had nothing to do with God. Probably he's questioning God. Why did you put me in this position? Maybe he was not very happy with his position. Imagine you are living in a palace and then suddenly cut to you are here. But then God is saying, I can begin conversation there because I have something for you and through you. So mission is about our master. It's all about God. But very interesting thing here, Moses knew who he's talking to. If you read further, God called to him, verse 4 says, when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see him, God called to him out of the bush, Moses, Moses, and he said, here I am. Remember this. It begins with him. You never serve mission because you want to do something. I want to tell you, we talked so much about Mission Sunday. He gave an elaborate report. He congratulated all of you. Fair enough. Yes, you did a great job. But it's not about you. Never begin with, I want to do something for God. Please, that's not mission. That's karma. I want to do something is what? It is karma, and that's not biblical principle. Biblical principle is very simple. It is from God. I will not be serving God on my terms. I don't want to do something for God. You cannot do anything for God. You may pat yourself, pat your back, I gave 10,000, I went to this place, that place. I am sorry, did God call you for that? Begana shadi mein, Abdullah diwana. There are a lot of people thinking they're doing mission, mission, mission. There is no God in their equation. You need to put master in the equation first. It has to begin from God. Today you watched a video, you get excited, give it away. I am sorry, that's not mission. You're serving Yashwant's great video. Sorry, Yashwant. But if God spoke to you through Yashwant, like the burning bush, if God begins to converse with you through that very video, that, hey son, hey daughter, I have a purpose for this. So don't be driven by emotions. It is not a heart decision. It's a heart and mind and spiritual decision. Mission begins with God. God telling you to do something, not Vijaykanth emotionally blackmailing you. I've been a missionary and I am an expert. I can make you emotional about all the sob stories I can tell you. And there are many in the market like that. दुकानें खोल रखी बहुत लोगों ने. पता है मैं बिहार से आया हूँ, थोड़ा हिंदी बोलूँगा चलेगा? दम आता है यार हिंदी में, अंग्रेजी में नहीं आता. What are we trying to do? Emotional blackmail. Sad people, mad people. अरे my mother also was a Hindu. She is still a Hindu. She does more charity than me, more than you. What? 1 crore. My temple trust gives more than that. Go to TTD. The difference is, we do because my Lord calls me. You do missions because God calls you. So do you hear God? Do you know God? If you don't know God, sorry, it's a self-praising exercise you're into. Chanda ka dhanda band karo. We don't need arms to serve God. We need you to serve God. We need you to listen to God. God needs you to listen to Him. He's saying, Moses, He calls him by name. God will call you by name about what you have to do. For that to happen, you need to know Him. Do you know God? Or do you know about God? Many Christians live in the memory of knowing Him. Understand? Knowing Him. I know Him. I know Vijaykant. I know this person. We throw names, no? Big shots. I know Billy Graham. I know Benny Hinn. I organize that program. They don't know you. But God knows you. But God is saying, will you come to me? Moses, Moses. So it's all about Him. So first thing, do you know your Master? It's all about His life, how He lived here, all about His death, how He died here, all about His resurrection, all about His second coming. Mission is this, that I have an intimacy with my God and I listen to Him every single day. Every moment, I'm in the awareness of Him being my Master. Most of our prayers tell us who is the Master in our lives. What do we pray? Lord, I'm going to Lemon Tree Hotel. Let the AC work there. Let me get the chair away from the speaker. Let me get the chair in the darkest corner so that the preacher cannot point at me. I'm going there. Take care. I am working here, bless me, I am doing this, come with me. Who is the Master? Who takes orders in our prayers? Hello? Who is taking orders? God is taking orders from us. So who is the Master? Your prayers tell you who is the Master. If God is my Master, I take orders from Him. I don't tell Him what to do. I ask Him what to do. Moses says, here I am. You know, when we go to God, I think God says, here again. Phir aa gaya, katora leke. Bhar de jholi mera. Is He your Master? Is He my Master? Mission is about Him taking the first step, not you taking a first step for Him. God is the initiator of mission. First in you, not outside. First He talks to you, He talks to me. Then He calls me by name, Vijay, I have something to tell you. That's the process. Do you know Him, really? If you don't know Him, please come to know Him. Please understand His voice. Please listen to His voice. Not be driven by emotions. Christians are very gullible. We are very nice people, okay? We are drawn by stories. But we are not supposed to be foolish. Because every resource that you have with you belongs to God. Every tear that you have in your eyes belongs to God. Don't even waste it. See, even while I want to serve people, I need to know whether it is the karma principle I'm following, whether I'm following God. Please understand this. There is a big problem in missions. As I travel around, trust me, I see it everywhere. God's resources being abused, misused, people forming churches like mushroom. Hindi mein hum log kukur mutta bolte. Anybody from Bihar here? UP, Bihar? No, Jharkhandi to hai hamara bhai. In case you don't know, he's from Jharkhand. Get up. Show your proud Bihari bhai. Yeah. No problem. Yeah. Jharkhand alag ho gaya to kya? Hum to Bihari hai. No problem. Yeah. Yeah. Like mushrooms, no? I'm always very happy when I hear a new church is formed. No, I'm a missionary. I want to see more churches come. But unfortunately, same members. New church should have new members, no? Church is growing, church is growing. Kya church is growing? I have 1,000 rupees here. I take 200 here, 200 here, 200 here, 200 here, 200 here. 5 church ban gaya. Dukane khol rakhi logon ne. Khol rahe. That's not church. That's not the will of God. Why would he put foolishly 5? He would put 1,000 here, 1,000 here, 1,000 here, 1,000 here. That's my God. If the church is growing, new people are coming. That's the heart of God. That's the heart of God. Ye nahi ki 5 kilo chawal kharid ka aadha aadha kilo baant diya sabko. He gives 5 kilo to everybody. So when you listen to God, you listen to the heart of God. God says, hey son, hey daughter, where you are, listen, I want to talk to you. Mission begins with the master. The second one, I. I don't know. Christians, we really don't know who we are. You want to do missions, really? How many of you want to do missions? Want to be part of missions? Can I see some hands? Yeah, only 2, 3. End of the service, I hope all of you will do it. What is the intention? Why missions? It is not to make somebody's life better, just that. You know, we want to support education, good. We want to build a house, very good. We want to give the medical insurance, very good. Excellent, we must do that. But if you stop there, that is not mission. Mission goes beyond this. Mission talks about eternal life. Mission is about giving people hope in Christ, telling people that Jesus came for them too, sharing that love with them. And this love is not our love, this is God's love. God loves them, therefore, again it comes back to God. God so loved the world, he gave his son. We didn't love the world. We cannot love the world the way God loves. So our intention in going into missions is we want to share this good news, saving mankind. How many of you believe Jesus is the only way? If you don't believe, please check your Bible. Because every Bible says, I am the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And that's a fact. If you believe sare raaste ek jagah jaate hain, that's a usual philosophy in India, no? All roads lead to, try that in Hyderabad. You miss one cut, you'll regret your life. You lose one heart of time, stuck in some traffic jam. All roads don't lead everywhere, one place. They go to different places. But yes, they partly go till a junction. Bible says that. All will go to one place. That is true. But the problem is that's a junction. What is that place? A place of judgment. No matter where you come from, no matter which caste, which religion, where you're born, if you don't know Christ or you know Christ, all of us will go to that same place. But that's where the trouble comes. Those who have Christ go with him. Those who don't have will not go with him. I don't want to say where else they'll go, that they'll figure out themselves. But since we know that all roads don't lead to the eternity, eternal life, that's the intention of God. He says, you go and tell others. So all roads lead to same place? Yes, half distance, not full distance, till judgment. But after judgment, only those who have Christ, that's what the intention is. God wants people to be saved, not to make their lives better here. What is the point giving them another 20, 30 years and still push them into hell? Right? I buy them a medical insurance, I give them a PhD degree. Then if they don't know Christ, what is the only problem is hell entry mein thoda time lag jayega. Doctor so and so come and settle in hell. You don't make their lives better for the sake of making their lives better. Mission is about getting them to Christ. You may not do it directly, you may do it indirectly. But whatever we are doing it, it is only for this to happen, that they know Christ. That's the intention behind missions. I did not know Christ for 25 years of my life. Born and brought up in upper caste Hindu family. Followed Islam for 5 years. Didn't know what is the truth. Believed in everything till I knew Christ. Amazing where God led me 20 years back. But the point is, do you have that heart of God in your missions? Missions is not about sending a child to school. It's about sending that child to heaven. So as you give, pray for salvation of the child, of the church or the ministry, wherever they're working. It's not just the buildings you're contributing to, it is to eternal life that you're contributing to. Mission is this. People ask me, are you mad? Why are you still in Bihar? I said, till Bihar is saved, I have to be there. Or till God calls me out. I travel a lot, but I'm still based there. Morning I was telling, you know what is a mission? My father-in-law, mother-in-law, they were both in army, in Indian army. My father-in-law would say he fought a couple of wars. Never with me, only with Pakistan. He tells me, mission for us means karo ya maro. Either you win or you die. That's mission. Mission means this, that either you win or you die. You don't come back without it. So what is mission today? Till the last person on this earth hears the gospel, God has a mission. And they're calling us to be on that mission. It's not simply a 500 rupees, 1000 rupees. Chillare baap, kuch nahi hota usse. Tomato 60 rupees kilo hamare Bihar mein. It doesn't add anything unless you give with the heart of saving people. Are you with me? The third one, S. I'm making it M-I-S-S-I-O-N to remember. What is the first one? Master. The third one is the sequence. What pattern that God follows? The sequence. Look at Moses. For Moses, God is saying, again, Exodus chapter 3, I have surely seen the affliction of my people who are in Egypt, and I have heard their cry because of their taskmasters. I know their sufferings, and I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians. Now God is talking to a person who is in trouble himself. Right? He is not in a very comfortable position. Now imagine if God comes to you and says, hey Moses, how are you doing? Vijay, how are you doing? You'll say, wow, lottery nikal gaya. Huh? Great time to ask. God is saying, I have come down. I'm talking to you, I have a relationship with you, but I want to talk to you about something else or somebody else. When God saves us, he wants to share his heart with us. It's not about we sharing our heart with him alone, but he wants to share his heart with us. That's the value he gives us. Who do we share our heart with? If I have a financial problem, where do I go? To pastor or to the Infosys general manager or whatever you call them? You know the right people to knock, no? ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, you know whom to talk to. You know the right people to talk. So when God talks to you and me, he considers us right people to share his burden. What a privilege. We think God is so powerful, so mighty, so we can go to him so that he can help us, isn't it? But now consider this. God is talking to us about his concern. What a privilege. What a place he is giving us. God sharing his concern. Are you with me? Do you understand what I'm saying? I don't see any excitement. Kya yaar, phas gaye. I get that vibes from you. See, when God is sharing his heart with us, means he considers us equals. What an honor. That's why when Chaitanya says, this is the best job in the world, I second him. I agree with him fully. That God makes us equals. I'm not saying your jobs are bad, by the way. In a moment you'll find out why it is good also. Not only pastors. I'm not even a pastor. I'm a pastor to pastors. That's a different thing. Okay. But God is saying, Moses, we have a relationship. You know me, I know you, we are talking to each other. I want to share something. What is the sequence? The sequence is that God saves you first. 2 Corinthians 5:17. If anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation. All old is gone, everything has become new. Wow, great. He took care of our past, he made us new, he gave us hope, he has great plans for us. Then the verse 18, he says, very beautifully, he gives us what? A ministry of reconciliation. The moment you are saved, you're a new creation, you become a Christian. The second thing, all of your Bibles say the same thing? He commits us a ministry of reconciliation. Ministry of reconciliation is people who are away from God need to be brought back to God. That is ministry of reconciliation. So the default mode for every Christian is you have a ministry. You don't believe me? Please look into your Bibles. 5:18, 2 Corinthians 5:18. So do you have a ministry? Do you have a ministry? I'm asking you. Because God gave you ministry. You don't know it yet. But if you read this Bible clearly, or you meditated upon it, you would have known it. 2 Corinthians 5:18 says, I have committed to you, I have given to you a ministry of reconciliation. All this is from God, but he gave us a ministry of reconciliation. So by that definition, every Christian is a missionary. You don't need a special calling. Some people come and tell me, whole room became white. Bihar, it'll never become white. We never have light. So if I wait for that miracle, it'll never come. You don't need all those great signs. You just read your Bible. See, those things happen for most stubborn people. He has to, you know, give a shock treatment. Jo dimag kharab hota, unko shock treatment milta. Normal walo ko vachan milta. You read your Bible, you don't need a calling. All of you. Do you believe in this Bible verse that says you have a ministry of reconciliation? So we are all default mode. You turn the AC on, it's at 24 degrees. That's default temperature, right? Your TV, it's 9 volume. Default. So as a default, when we are a new creation, when we are Christians, what happened? We are already having a ministry. What is the ministry? Ministry of reconciliation. Say to each other, I am a missionary. Okay, you're not an obedient missionary, that we'll talk about it later. But you are given a ministry. Because you are a Christian, the moment you are a new creation, ministry is already given to you. You don't need a special calling for that. Special calling is for ministries like this, teaching, preaching, pastoral, that specific ministry God calls. But for reconciliation, meaning evangelism, you don't need a call. It's already there. Every Christian is given a ministry of reconciliation. Verse 19 says, you are given the word of reconciliation. You don't need to worry, what will I speak? Some Christians tell me, brother, you know Bible, I don't know Bible. How is it that I know Bible and you don't know Bible? I read, you don't read. That is all. You can break those dummy codes 10001122 pata nahi kya kya aapka computer mein. You can't decode this Bible, such a small thing, with the Holy Spirit living in you. We don't know because we don't love it. Kitabe bahut si padi hogi tumne. My daughter just wrote her NEET exam. My goodness, if I had studied like that, I would have been NASA scientist. When it comes to Bible, world's best sleeping pill. Isko nikala, life jingalala. Especially Old Testament, two verses guarantee solid sleep. My God gives me rest. John 3:16, class 10 pass. Okay. Psalm 23, inter pass. Psalm 1, degree. One more, PhD, finished. Mission, you have given the word of God. You want to be part of mission? I'm not saying you'll know the entire word. We'll not understand many things in the word. Especially Old Testament is tough. Sometimes we don't know whether it is a city name or a place name or a person's name. It's very difficult, right? But doesn't matter. Bible is not for understanding. Bible is for obeying. What you understand, you obey. I understood that there is a sequence in missions. that he saves me, he gives me ministry, he gives me the word to preach, word to save. And it's available for all of us, not for only theologians. Thank God for the reformist movement that happened. Thank God for Martin Luther King and people like that who fought for the Bible to come to us. Thank God for people like William Carey who got it into our own languages. We have it in Bhojpuri. Can you imagine? Lovely. Always thought, you know, how will my Bhojpuri brothers sing? They sing amazing songs. They write their own Bhojpuri worship songs. It's a dialect, in case you don't know, spoken in Eastern UP and Bihar. We have this, but do we use it? And verse 20, he says, 2 Corinthians 5:20, therefore you're Christ ambassadors. Ambassador doesn't represent himself, he represents a nation. You represent the kingdom of God wherever you are. You're a Christian, you're an ambassador. It's a default mode. You don't need a calling for that. So as you sign those forms, as you commit your life to God, I want to ask you this question. Do you have this sequence? Are you in the right place before you give that money away? Do you understand that you're called to be a witness? Acts 1:8 says, you will receive Holy Spirit and you will receive power and you will become my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria and ends of the world. We all want to go to ends of the world. I don't know why ends of the world ends only in America, never in Africa or Andaman. From there they will say, my mentor Brother Rajkumar says, in US and Canada when he preaches, people come and say, brother, our heart is in India. He said, what is the body doing in America? You're an ambassador of God. What kind of an ambassador you are? Daru Masi, Khaini Masi, Bivi Maru Masi? Itwari Lal, Tyohari Lal? Sunday Christians, no? Super Christians on Sunday. Praise the Lord, brother. Praise the Lord, sister. Ah, heaven comes down. Goodness me, all hell breaks out when you get out. But Jerusalem is where your ministry begins. You want to serve people in Kenya? Are you serving your church? There is a sequence there too. You'll be my witness in Jerusalem. This is your Jerusalem. Are you serving your church? Or are you getting nice massage and going? Some people come for massage, not for message. You are good. You are great. Tusi mahano, tusi greato, kya maal diya, maja aa gaya, kya gaana gaya, Sylvan, maja aa gaya, maja lene aate. You don't come here for massages. You come here to listen to the messages and share it there. Please understand the heart of God. You are an ambassador, you're a great person, you know that? You represent God, God of all heaven. I came to Christ at my workplace. I'm a doctor, not theological doctor, theologically illiterate, totally. In my hospital, the nurses I worked with, the doctors I worked with, amazing Christians, they didn't have to preach the gospel. I was shocked. I said, can humans be so good? That to Christians, to top it all, can Christians be so good? That was my question. Christians were for me, free daru na. That's the only Christians I knew. Easy girlfriends, free drinks. My college life was like that. My Christian relationships were like that. But till I went to this hospital where I saw these amazing people, they didn't preach the gospel to me. I was a professional. Come from an upper caste. Staunch Hindu family. Work for some fundamental organizations. I used to raise funds for some of these fundamental organizations myself as a young boy. But these Christians were amazing witnesses. They were the ambassadors of God. They didn't have to preach. I went and asked, who are you? What makes you different? How can you not get angry with these patients? I'll tell you a story. I think I shared last time. You know, Bihar, it's very difficult, huh? Patients. You sit in the cabin, the patient comes to you ask, what's your problem, right? Takleef kya hai? You know what they tell me? Tum doctor, tum batao. Come on, where do I begin? But then you want to bash them up, okay?
You get irritated, hundreds of people waiting, you want to finish the OPD fast, but these fellows will irritate you like this. But the Christian doctors, the Christian nurses, what love, what patience. Genuine, they were not faking it. You can't fake it for 10, 20, 30 years. I said, Lord, there is something in these people, I want to know that. They introduced me to Christ. In fact, they introduced me to Bible. I read the Bible, came to the Lord in 40 days. Nobody converted me. God chose me. What is your witness? There are many Vijays working with you, seeking the truth, trying to figure out the purpose of their life. You don't know Bible, doesn't matter. You can live the Bible. You don't know how to quote verses from Bible, doesn't matter. You can obey the verses that God spoke to you. That's mission, friends. Being a witness is not blabbering. 2,000 years we have been preaching, 2%, shame on us. We stopped preaching better. I think we did a horrible job preaching. 2,000 years back, Thomas came to this country, right? America was not even discovered. When was US discovered? 400 years, right? You should know America, IT people. America was not even discovered when gospel came to my country. It's a shame on me that I take support from America for gospel. Disgraceful on India that instead of we sending missionaries to those countries, we are receiving funds from them, we want them to help us. Shame on us. You know what? Because we have not converted truly. Because we have not known cross truly. Because we have not known God truly. My Jesus that I know, my Bible tells me something else from what the other Christians tell me. There is a sequence. Where are you in that sequence? Mission is this. And the next S is servant-like service. You don't serve from the position of authority. When I'm giving, I'm not giving because I'm a rich man or I have a big heart. No. You count it a privilege to serve these people. I count it a joy to serve my Bihari brethren. It's an honor that God bestows on me to be able to serve these people. They give me an opportunity to show the love of God. But for them, what will I do? It's a privilege to serve these people, to show the love of God. Once my patient told me in a jokingly way, I was telling him, you know, don't eat this pan, gutka, you get cancer and all those things. He tells me, if I don't eat, what will you do? You get all kinds of patients there. You'll be jobless if I don't get disease. He was doing a favor to me, it seems. Hum bimar honge, aap tabhi doctor banenge. On the other side, I say, Lord, there are hundreds and hundreds of people, thousands of people, better than me, more qualified than me, more capable than me, but you choose me to serve these people. As we speak, my house is flooded. My home is flooded. My hometown is flooded in Bihar right now. My wife, my children are in need of water. Not my house, we are on the third floor, thankfully, but my entire church, everybody is in water right now as we speak. In fact, when I left home, it was all getting flooded on Friday. But do I come here? Yes, I do come here. It's a privilege for me to serve you. I've not come here because I know a lot of Bible, by the way. Some of you might be better than me. I've come here because God told me, go and serve this church. I will come and serve you. When you give to people, what is your attitude? Do you go to them with an attitude of service? Oh, I want to serve you. They become our masters, the people whom we serve. These children become our masters. We are taking orders from them. How can I help you? So missions is not about we being somewhere. We are blessed, so we give. No, it is blessed to give. It's a privilege to give. My wife and I, both of us doctors, we have been there in that place for so many years. I tell you, it's a joy. It's a great joy. Great privilege to serve him. But I'm not saying you have to come to Bihar to serve. The point I'm making is, are you serving where God has placed you? And how do you serve? By being a witness. By being a servant to these people. Not getting irritated at your non-Christian colleagues. Not cursing them. These fellows always do this nonsense. They don't know, therefore they do. Love them. If they irritate you more, increase the love. Dose badao. We choose the easy path. What do we say?
You take care of your life. I'm not responsible for you. Husband, wife also do this. I don't know why Christian marriages are breaking. Shame on us. Our own friendships, our own relationships are breaking. Shame on us. What kind of witness we are? Servant-like. Why? So that we can win them for Christ. Then the next one. Next I. Invest. You have to invest. It's not just money. The moment I say invest, everybody is looking here. This fellow has come. Ab mudde pe baat kar raha Bihari. Bada bhashan de raha tha, paisa mangega. Sorry, we don't need your money. God needs you. Whole package. Either whole of you or nothing. God demands 100%. Nothing more, nothing less. I keep giving this illustration, very bad illustration though, but it makes sense. Either you're 100% faithful to God or you're not. There is nothing called 99% faithful. Can I say I'm 99% faithful to my wife? Only once in a year, for a week, I take a break and go with somebody. Am I faithful to my wife? If I did that, I don't do it. Don't give me those looks. If I say, I'm faithful to my wife, I love her, but in a year, 1 week, I take a break. 99% I'm faithful. Am I faithful? 99.5%, 3 days, Hyderabad, Lemon Tree, nice hotel. 3 days in a year, I take a break. New Year party here. Am I faithful to her? No. 1 day, half a day, 1 hour? It's either 100% or nothing. God demands 100%. All that you have, your whole being, not just your purse, not just your money. Don't put God in a box and think that I have done my tithes, I have done my offering, my job is done. No, sir. Everything belongs to Him. When God called Moses, Moses was making excuses. Chapter 3 and 4, if you read, I can't speak, I can't do this. You know the story, right? I'm not going back there. So what does God say? What do you have? Whatever is there in your hand, give it. You know that, no? And God worked with that. God took entire Moses, full body Moses, with what he had in his hand and used him. Whatever is there in your hand, whatever God has blessed you with, you have time, please give. I think this is a great ministry, giving time. In our situations, I know I counsel a lot of people, especially from cities, and I have no one to talk to. And these fellows always talk to me at 12:30 in the night. My wife says, who are these fellows here? Why they call you at 12:30, 1 o'clock in the night? I say, no, that's the only time they feel free. No. Do we have time to talk to people? Our homes are open. Listen to people more than talk. No, talking, I think we do. Listen to people. Hurting. People are hurting. Your own family might be hurting. Husband, wives, don't talk. Some homes, father comes, share aagya, na? My goodness, this fellow came, now we'll start demanding chai, coffee, everything, he'll start shouting. Wife goes to kitchen, keeps washing the vessels he already washed. Why face this fellow? Do we have communication? Do we have time for each other? In the church? Do we know each other? You have been coming to this church? Do you know all the worship leaders' names? I don't want to embarrass you, but it's shame on you if you don't know even their names. Do you even know the ushers who meet you every Sunday? Do you even know the volunteers? Mission is this. Your Jerusalem is this. Begin here. Stop doing window shopping. Stick to one grocery shop. You'll get good discounts. My father taught me this. Ek hi dukaan se lo beta, achha maal milega, sasta maal milega. Bar bar dukaan nahi badalne ka. You know, shopkeeper also salutes, no? Saab aa gaye, kya achha lagta button shop mein? Saab, aapka piece abhi bana raha hai. Take pride, no? Some station, even the coolies know me, okay? Saab aa gaye, my daughter says, what's wrong with even the coolies know you? I travel so much. but you feel good about it. Same with church. Your Jerusalem. Hello? Malum hai, padosi ka naam kya hai? Do you know her? Behind you. Every time, same people. Aaj lal chudi pehen ke aayenge. Tum bhi blue pehenna, hum bhi hara pehenenge. Same people you want to sit. That's not church, that's not Jerusalem, that's chaos. Minister here, minister one another, minister at your office, that's ministry. Don't have to come to Bihar for that. God calls you, come. But your calling is right here, your ministry is here. You are wondering, no, where is the ministry? I'm telling you, where is the ministry? Where can I be witness? Witness here, witness the love of God here. Witness the servant-like attitude here. Morning service, I was telling, I was mad at Chaitanya yesterday. He was coming here at 4 in the morning, he's leaving home at 4 and calling me at 4:30 to wake up his son. Shame on you here, you don't even let the guest speaker sleep. Please wake up, I was sleeping in the same room with Hoshia. I was saying, what are you doing at 4 in the morning? Why are you going there? I thought some prayer work he's doing. Nice spiritual man. No, I had to set up the mics. So what happened? Don't you read Bible? In Acts chapter 5, when there is a problem, 6 I think, of serving, no, widows, people are fighting, my widows are not getting. So Peter and John, they come and complain. So Peter and John say, hey, we have to dedicate our time for what? Prayer and ministry. Serving food and all is not our job. We will appoint somebody. They appointed people, including Stephen. We need Stephens in the church. Are you there? No, I want to be Peter and John only. You don't give me, I'll start a church. Bimari hai ye. Khud bhi dubenge, sabko dubayenge. Become Stephen first. Maybe God will elevate you to Peter and John. But even if you have to die like Stephen, what a privilege to die like Stephen. At least you will not be Judas. खाया पिया सब कुछ और छेद करके भाग गया. इन्वेस्टमेंट, आर यू इन्वेस्टिंग इन योर जेरूसलम? यस, देन जूडिया, देन समरिया, देन केनिया. यस, कम, वेलकम. इफ यू आर नॉट डूइंग इट फॉर योर सेल्स राइट हियर इन द चर्च, इफ यू डोंट सर्व ईच अदर, डोंट इवन थिंक अबाउट अदर्स. सॉरी, गॉड डजंट नीड इट. आई ऑलवेज एनकरेज पीपल, यू वॉन्ट टू सपोर्ट अवर मिनिस्ट्री, हाउ इज योर रिलेशनशिप विथ योर चर्च? Is your pastor taken into confidence that you support us? We serve in many countries. We serve in about 15 countries. But I always tell people, don't ever support me or the ministry that I am part of without your pastor's knowledge. You need to be faithful to your church first. That's where God placed you. You serve there, then you serve us apart from that, over and above that. That's the way it is done. I'm telling you, I am not a Capstonian. In fact, it's a loss for me to preach something like this. You're all rich cows, no? Khoop doodh nikal sakte. Lot of people are milking. But Bible teaches otherwise, kya karun? Majboori hai. Bible se hat ke bol nahi sakta. I'll be punished. So where is your loyalty? Even in missions, loyalty must begin with your own church. Spread across. Go around. Go beyond. Many of you serve along with us. Many of your members serve along with us, but Chaitanya knows each one of them. Even if they don't tell, I tell Chaitanya that these are your partners. These are your church members who are helping us. Are you faithful? Are you faithful investing your time, your talent, and treasure? All that you have in your local church where God has placed you. Don't be running away from your church and try to serve God. That won't work. This is the church where God has placed you for mutual edification, not for your own edification. When we come together, we are supposed to edify each other. That's the biblical teaching. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, if you go and read, no time today. Are you edifying each other? So make it a pledge that you are going to invest time into each other's lives. Not to gossip around. Pata na kya samajhti bar bar tight pant pehen ke aati hai. अरे वो वजन कम करना चाहते, मुझसे पूछो ना. आई डोंट बाई द नेक्स्ट सेस सो दैट आई कैन रिड्यूस माई वेट. If I buy the next size, I'm finished, no? Adjust ho jayenge naye size mein. Don't judge people. Love them. Accept them. Edify them. Encourage them. People are broken. Behind a big smile, there's a lot of hurt. They have troubles at home. Ask them. Pray for them. Invite them over for a meal. Not an expensive meal, but a simple meal. Give an ear to their cries. That's the investment God wants. O. Overcome challenges. There will be challenges. Mission is never a cakewalk. It is a tough place to be because it is God's work. If you don't do anything, you'll not be any problem, okay? That's guaranteed. Devil is very smart. He doesn't waste his time on people who are complacent. You come to church 11 to 1 or 12:30 to 1 according to your convenience. You don't do anything for God, give your tithe and go, he will not trouble you. But the moment you start witnessing, the moment you want to live for God, he will begin to trouble you. So you have to overcome those challenges. In the mission, there will be challenges. I came to the Lord, I told in 2000, till now, my parents have not met me back. They have legally thrown me out, taken me to court. We are three brothers, I am the oldest. 500 rupees and four pairs of clothes I had. Took me to court, signed off all the documents that I have nothing to do with them. Property wise, everything. Everything is gone. They have not even seen my children. My older one is 17, younger one is 13. I served the Lord in so many countries, and the Lord in his mercy showed me hundreds of people turning to the Lord. But my own parents, my own brothers, don't know the Lord. What a background. Crying for me. It hurts. It does hurt that my parents don't know my children. My children don't know them. They're not seen. Grandma, grandpa, they don't know. My brothers got married. They have children. I don't know how they even look. Their wives or their children. I don't even know. They don't even know my children. All these years, still ongoing struggle. Challenges are there. But how do I overcome? I overcome because I know God is in control. I don't have to take control in my hands. I should not fret and cry and, you know, stop doing what God called me to do. I keep doing what I'm doing. God gave me hundreds of parents. God gave me hundreds of brothers. God gave me hundreds of nieces and nephews. This guy, little guy, Kenzie. You know Kenzie boy? May not be. Kishan and Zalita's son. Oh, goodness me. We hardly meet once in a year or twice in a year. But the way he comes to me, I can sleep in the same room as Hoshia. I can hug Jeannie as my own daughter, Dolly. These are my nephews and nieces. Janet is my sister-in-law. My sister bolunga. Sister-in-law thoda gadbad ho jayega. Rishta karab ho jayega. Beheni theek hai. Bhabhi gadbad ho jayega. Theek hai, Chaitanya bhav garu. Okay. Hundreds. Maybe I'm counting less. Every state in this country, I have families where I can walk in, throw off my clothes for washing, they will iron it and give it back to me. My brother wouldn't have done that ever. He would have paid for the dhobi, but he wouldn't wash my clothes. Janet can wash my underwears. That's the love we share. I'm sorry, Janet, I have to share this. Who would give me? I overcome challenges by looking at what God is giving, not what God is not giving. Mission is this, that we face challenges every day, but we move on. We don't stop because circumstances are not comfortable. The last point is that never give up, never stop doing what God has called you to do it. That's mission. It's either die in mission or win in mission. There is no third choice. You want to be on the mission? There is no choice. You better be on the mission. Because God, when he commits something, he'll hold you accountable. He committed the ministry of reconciliation to you. He committed the word of reconciliation to you. He called you to be an ambassador. He is going to call an account for that. Be prepared for that. No escape. After this sermon, definitely no escape. God will remind you. I think they'll put it on YouTube also, in case you forget. So, are you a missionary? Not yes. Raise your hands. If you believe that you are a Christian, you are a missionary. Even if you don't like it, I'm sorry. Even if you don't like it, you're a disobedient missionary. You're a wicked missionary. crooked missionary, convenient missionary, whatever missionary you want to add, anything, any adjectives you can add, free, feel free, but you are a missionary. You like it or not, your mission field is as long as there are people without Christ, that's a mission field. Everyone with a Christ is a missionary. Everyone without Christ is a mission field. Will you be the witness to these people? Moses was Moses because of that. With all his weaknesses, with all his problems, he reluctantly nevertheless moved. You know what happened in the end? Did Moses reach where he was supposed to reach? He didn't reach. He didn't reach. 40 years of struggling with these fellows who are remembering garlic and ginger and whatnot. Irritating fellows. Poor guy, no? Such struggle. And to top it all, in the end, he says, now train Joshua. You will not enter, train Joshua. Hum hote kya bolte? Rakh apna lathi, hum ja rahe. Sasural. Sajan chale sasural. But Moses did that. Moses developed Joshua. He said, God, this is your will. I belong to you. It's not that I have to be blessed. People are blessed, no? You want to bless them, no? You want to use me, I'll be consumed. If I don't have to build my house, if I can build somebody's house, I would do that. That's what I like about Capstone. That's why I'm attached to Capstone. You don't have your own building, but you want to talk about building 14 churches, 40 churches. Are you mad, Chaitanya? What kind of leader you are choosing? Apna church building nahi, hotel se pata nahi kahan kahan bhag rahe. But he wants to build churches outside. That is leadership. That's biblical leadership. Moses didn't care if I enter or not. He developed others. Capstone must grow in this even more. All of you must grow in this even more. You don't care about your building. Your building will come. You know what? Great things take time. Dum biryani mein time lagta. Pulao mein koi time nahi lagta. Aapka dum biryani ban raha hoga. But in the meantime, he's saying, will you distribute the pulao for others? Mission is this. Mission is this. Are you with God? Are you listening to God? Are you obedient to God? Never give up. Never stop doing what you're doing. And no work is small. No work is big. Everything is great because we serve this wonderful God. Taking this down to the hall, to the storeroom, is a big work for God. Don't just walk away. Stop by and ask, can we do something? How are you winding up? You know this is not your building, no? You can't go beyond three. They'll charge you. Will you ask voluntarily? I know there are some volunteers here, but we need more people to work. More the merrier. No, no, no. Pastor never calls us. He introduced the whole team. Volunteer ko bulaye nahi, hum nahi aayenge. Don't call them. They're not volunteers. Bible says, if you receive your reward here, nothing upstairs. Better store up there. Yahan Chaitanya tarif kiya to ghata hai. Isliye I tell him not to introduce too much. Thank you for learning, reducing the introductions. Yahan tarif hoga to wahan kya milega? Better, no? That we serve silently with all that we have. So will you close your eyes for a moment? Look at your own lives. If God has spoken to you, I want you to speak to Him back. Go back to Him and say, Lord, thank you for calling me your child. Thank you for calling me your missionary. Thank you for assigning me the church, assigning me the ministry that I am doing around this place. Close your eyes, please. Close your eyes, please. Just meditate on whatever God has spoken to you.